Hello everyone, Thunderbolt 1000 Siren Productions here. Here it is, the first double-headed steam excursion on the Reading and Northern since 1988. With 425 and 2102 in command, crossing through North Reading Yard here to hook up to their train. Me and Snuggleby will be chasing the train from North Reading here to Jim Thorpe and back, so sit back and enjoy. Here we are at Morrisville, with too many rail fans to count as the excursion rockets through. Now we'll pace the two through New Ringgold. Please do not try this yourself. I'm a professional idiot. Also, note to self, the Canon Rebel's stock microphone doesn't fare up too well with whistles. I'm not too surprised by that. To be honest, if it weren't for the foliage, this would have been a good pacing shot. Oh well, whatever. Considering the convoy of railfans that day, I wasn't even going to try to attempt pacing again at Zenner's, so our traditional curve shot should do right by the mines. I should apologize for the scratch mark on the camera lens. When this excursion took place, my main camcorder broke from a fall, and my backup one of the same model had a scratched lens, but still worked. I tried my best to hide it from ruining shots, but I could only do it so much. I should also point out my buddy Train Fan 5202 was on board the excursion in the dome car. Lucky bugger. See if we can spot him. He's got a chessy cap on. Let's go see what's in the gorge today.
I'm being honest, the hooter's a little bit louder.
Now to why the excursion around. 2102 did all the work while 425 was basically just along for the ride. What's strange is the helpers didn't even assist on the Y move like they normally did, but eh, whatever.
Oh. Championship.
Excuse me.
Goes the helper set turning the private cars around. Consist. Thank you. After a quick top-up of coal and water, mainly for 425, the two engines back up one at a time for cab tours. We're only going to get a quick peek of 425 and 2102's cabs due to time and the ginormous crowd. I've been in both before, but I couldn't help myself doing a little tour.
Keep it moving.
15270.
Oh, there you go.
Yep. Out of one cab into the other. How convenient.
What do you think? Pretty big cab, isn't it?
And the stoker's somewhere back there. Can't really see it. Well, that's what that clicking noise is.
Thank you!
And another one!
Thank you.
Now this is what I like to call a parade of iron horses. Or just 425 and 2102 getting themselves in position for the return trip. Funny thing is, a lot of people, myself included, expected 2102 to lead to Jim Thorpe and 425 to lead for Port Clinton. Would have been poetic, but nah. I personally, though, don't mind. The fact the two were doubleheading at all was worth celebrating about.
Thank you.
Next up, oh boy, the photo run-by. And just look at that crowd by the station. There's more people than platform. Oh, by the way, remember that Halloween video I did titled Lost Spectre? This is where I got that ghost whistle audio clip. Well, that was fun. Let's back it up to pick up the passengers. Should have left them behind. Save coal and water from the extra weight. Oh, come on, I'm only kidding. Thank you. Snuggleby, get the camera. Here they come.
Oh.
Oh, it's just the helpers getting ahead of the train to Port Clinton. Oopsie, false alarm. Alright, for real this time. Unfortunately, due to only two steam crews being on duty and the added headache of spinning two steam engines out of Y, not one, those fast-rate SD-50-2s we saw earlier will take the excursion from here at Port Clinton, unload the necessary passengers, then press on to Reading to let everyone else off. I fully understood, though. SD-50-2s are cool. XCSX ones, too.
Yeah, because CSX seems to never leave you alone.
Oh, shut up.
Sorry, Snuggleby. I couldn't help myself. You live in CSX territory anyway. Ooh, here they come.
Coming, bell's ringing.
What?
Coming, the bell is ringing.
Yeah, you're right.
Tastes good?
Depends.
Compliments to the chef?
No? Probably.
All right.
Here we go.
Rich.
Thank you.
Steady, Andy. Hey!
All right, let's put everything away. Oh, I see 425 has already been spun on the turntables and the shops already. 2102 will come in a minute, but she's too big to spin on the turntable, though. And well, that's it for the two steam engines, but we're not done. After a quick food break at a local Rudder's, here's the SD50-2's coming back to spin the empty excursion set around. I think we've seen enough. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.